Okay, so I want to get back into this story. Thank you if you guys watch the last few videos. Then you know what happened after I wrote these letters to my aunt. So I really didn't want to argue with them. And I know my aunt, I know she went around and she showed everybody the letter. She showed her daughter. She showed my Aunt Betty. She showed my Aunt Betty's husband. Everybody read those letters. No, that's the way that these people roll. Like, there's nothing private. When you have this big family, you know, everybody thinks that your business is their business. So they go around and they're very gossipy and they tell each other things. So I know she probably only, you know, showed what I wrote and what I did and not the part where she was being, you know, pretty nasty to me. Because that's how they, you know, if you want to present things in a certain way, they're going to present it in the way that's going to make them look like the innocent ones and me look like the bad guy. So I didn't talk to them for months after that. I just kind of cut off communication with them and went about my business and went on with my life of just caring for my mom because that was what I had to do. That summer, my mom got, you know, she got better to the point where she was able to, like, care for herself. Like, I didn't have to go over there as much, but she got worse in this sense. Medically was not doing good. Like, her, you know, she kept getting this anemia. She kept having breathing problems, like, really bad over the summer. Her breathing got really bad. And then she started coughing blood up, and it started getting, like, worse. You know, so I started going to all her doctor's appointments with her and, like, taking notes and just, like, keeping good records of all her medication and all that kind of shit. So, June, you know, nothing really eventful happened. We get into July. My mom's birthday is July 30th. So, my brother's wife decided to have a birthday party for their daughter, who is turning one. Her birthday is in April. First week of April, I think. I don't even know what her birthday is. Isn't that sad? I don't know what my own niece's birthday is. I know it's the first week of April, or it could even be the second week. Whatever. When she met my brother, she had this, like, really nice house. It was, you know, it wasn't a huge house, but it was like a split-level ranch. There's, like, it's like the Long Island special. Like, as soon as you walk in, there's a staircase. You could either go up or down. Okay, so she lives in this split-level ranch. You know, she had this beautiful backyard. She had this huge pool. She lived on a cul-de-sac, which, you know, like, who wouldn't want that? But for some reason, she felt like she needed a bigger house, right? And I think this is, like, her thing. Because if you look her name up on, like, one of those search sites, she's moved, like, 1,000 times. I'm like, how many fucking houses have you lived in? Like, I've lived 3 places my whole life. I lived home with my parents and my mom. And then I moved in with my husband to an apartment, and then we bought this house, literally, 3 places, my whole entire life. And I know, I'm not saying anything's wrong with moving. I know a lot of people have to do it for work or other reasons, or they rent apartments and stuff like that. But she has bought and sold, like, so many houses. I mean, I think it's just part of the personality that she can't just, like, sit still. She has to, like, you know, always have something kind of exciting going on in life to look forward to. Like, she can never just be happy with, like, how her life is. I don't know, whatever. There goes my psych evaluation. So they move into this house. I didn't see the house. They showed my mom the house in April, and then I guess they closed on it, I want to say, in May. So I get it. They had to postpone the baby's party, right? But they could have had it, you know, somewhere else, or they could have just had a small party, or had it a little later, a couple weeks later, whatever. No, she decides to have the baby's birthday, okay? The baby's birthday is the beginning of April, guys. She decided to have a party for this baby on my mom's birthday, July 30th. So she sends out the invitations, and this is the first time I'm invited to their house. The first time. I didn't want to go. And the reason I didn't want to go was more because of my family than it was my brother and his wife. So anyway, okay, so Satan decides to throw this birthday party. Now, I hadn't seen them in a while, and I didn't want to see my family. My mom still didn't know about this whole fight that I had with my aunt. But she started to notice that something was up because she was like, you know, you post pictures of Jesse and nobody comments on them. But then, like, my husband would post a picture and all of a sudden everybody likes it. You know, like I would post a picture of my son and nobody from my family would like it or comment on it or anything. I just, like, I didn't want to go to this party. I just did not want to go. And, you know, I really just wasn't feeling comfortable. My mom started kind of noticing something was up. Like, she was starting to get the hint that something was going on because she's like, nobody's commenting on your shit. Nobody's like, nobody talks to you. Nobody calls you. Like, what? Nobody even asks about you. Like, what's going on? And I just kind of played it off. I was like, I don't know, Mom, you know, I don't know what's going on. So this party's coming up, okay? And it's like a couple of, I don't know if it was like a week before the party or a couple of days, I forget now. And I'm panicking. And I just gotta tell you guys something. From that situation that happened back in the day 10 years ago, like, I used to love going to family parties. I used to look forward to it. It got to a point when that thing that took place years ago at my cousin's, where I would get anxiety before going to family parties from that point out, because I always felt guilty. It's like, my cousin's gonna see pictures of all of us. Like, I can't imagine being in her shoes and seeing pictures online of your family together and knowing that you can't be there and knowing that they're just kind of going on with life like you don't even exist anymore. Like, that's upsetting to me. And so it used to give me anxiety all the time. Like, my family's like, if you don't show up, they're like, oh, what the fuck? Like, why didn't you come? Blah, 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 blah. You're going to hurt Nana's feelings. They always use my grandmother. You know, Nana's going to be upset that you're not there. Not to be an asshole, I love my grandmother to death, but, like, she doesn't give a shit if we don't show up. I don't think she gets that upset by it. Like, I've never seen my grandmother, like, upset. The only time I've ever really seen her upset is at my grandfather's funeral. Other than that, like, she's not an emotional person. Like, she's always happy. She's kind of just like one of those people that just floats along in life that's happy all the time. And she doesn't really get, like, mad or upset or anything. But they always use that. So I was, at this point in time, I was so stressed out, you know, between taking care of my mom, because I still was doing, like, her food shopping and helping her out with things, bringing her to doctor's appointments, running back and forth. And I was like, I really don't want to go to this party. Like, at this point in time, I was just done with my family. I was done. I was like, dude, I put up with this shit for the last, you know, 12 years since this incident happened. And I just don't want to put up with it anymore. I'm done. I don't want that in my life anymore. I felt like I was being invited just because, like, it was, like, the right thing to do. I didn't talk to my brother, like, that whole summer. Supposedly we're talking again, but I didn't hear from him ever. He never called me. I never heard from him. I just, like, the whole situation, I just had anxiety about, and I just didn't want to go. But I was like, fuck, I gotta tell my mom this, that I don't want to go. And she's gonna want to know why. My husband was like, I'm not going. I am done with these fucking people. You know, my husband saw everything that was happening. He was a witness to it. So he knows everything that went down. And he's like, you know, you bend over backwards and you get treated like shit in return. I'm like, okay, well, I'm not going by myself. That's for sure. I'm not going to just show up, you know? I don't know. So I call my mom up and I'm like, Mom, I don't think I'm going to go to, you know, the baby's party. And she's like, what are you kidding me? She was pissed at me. Pissed at me. And I'm like, Mom, I just don't want to go. Like, I'm so stressed out. I just don't want to deal with it. I just don't. She's like, you know, you're going to ruin everything. I'm like, you know what? I don't want a relationship where it's like, I don't come to your house and you're going to fucking be mad at me and never talk to me again. Like, listen, I'm going to tell them I have something else to do that day. That's all. I'm just going to tell them I already had a prior engagement that day. Let me just tell you guys something. They put the invitation out and there was no mention of it being my mom's birthday. Like, she made the invitation and there was no, like, you know, not even like a little fucking 8-point size font at the bottom, like, you know, oh yeah, by the way, it's Carol's birthday that day, why don't you, you know, bring a present for her or something. I tell my mom, I'm like, you know, I just don't want to go. It's not even about my brother, it's about, you know, everybody else. I haven't talked to this one or that one. So I finally broke down and told her. I was like, listen, Mom, I hysterically cried while I was telling her this, because everything just kind of surfaced at that moment when I was telling her. I'm like, I was really concerned about you. You know, I'm so worried about you. And this is all I told her. That I said, I reached out to Aunt Debbie and Aunt Betty. And I wrote them a letter because I was so concerned about you because you seem very depressed. And what they replied to me, it just pissed me off and I went off on them. And it's my fault. I went off on them. I told them to fuck off. I thought she was gonna be really upset. But when I finally sat down and I explained it all to her, I wrote her like a long text message or something. I was just like, I've been running around and, you know, I'm not talking to them and I just don't want to feel uncomfortable. I just, you know, I don't want to do that to myself anymore. I'm so stressed out. I just need a break. I'm going to sit this one out. So go get the baby a gift. I went out. I spent like, I don't know, $100 on her. I kind of mailed it to them. I don't even remember. I sent it like before the party. I was like, you know, sorry, we can't make it. We have plans that day. And I sent it. My mom was okay with it. And I told her, I'm like, you know, I've been with you on your birthday for the last 3 years. You spend your birthday with him. I need a break from everything and everybody. Please understand and please respect my decision as an adult, as a grown woman, to make that decision for myself and my family. You know, in my head, I thought it was really fucked up. Some people might look at it like, oh, that was nice. She had the party on your mom's birthday. I looked at it like this. What if this is her last birthday on Earth, right? Why is she being outshined by a one-year-old? Shouldn't her birthday be about her and her only? So I told her. I said, I'm going to come over on Sunday. Her birthday was on a Saturday that year. I said, I'm going to come over on Sunday and we'll spend your birthday, just us, and it'll be about you and not a baby. Then after that, she wanted to see those letters. I said, Mom, I don't think you need to deal with this bullshit right now. It's all bullshit. Don't worry about it. So I found out later that she called up my mom's youngest sister. And she even said this to me. She said the same thing to me. My mom and I were honest with each other. She's like, I know you could be a bitch, Liana, but I also know how my sister is, Debbie. So she knew. And I took the blame for it. Like, I told her, I'm like, Mom, it was all me. It was me. It was me. It's not them. Because I felt like her fighting with them was not going to help the situation. So I just put it all on me. I was like, listen, it's my fault. I cursed them out. I was the asshole. Don't even ask them about it. Normally, I probably would have showed my mom those letters, but I felt like my mom would have been so hurt by how dismissive her sisters were about her depression. Like, I wasn't showing my mom that. What they wrote and how uncaring and cold it was towards my mom, I just didn't want to expose her to that. I felt like, no, I can't do that to her. She would have been devastated if she saw that shit. If she saw how they were just like, oh, you know, I'm busy with my grandkids. I think that would have hurt her more than anything. I think my aunt always felt like my mom owed her something because she donated the kidney. And so it was like, you fucked up the chance I gave you, so you're on your own, you know? I kind of do. I feel like that. I'm just assuming. I don't know if that's how she really feels, but. So now it's a couple of days before the party. My mom knows I'm not coming, right? It's like 2-3 days before the party. Let me stop this one and I'm going to go into the next one.